This screencast is based upon the problem set, two problems from the problem set for Module 2, Lesson 5. It shows you how to use the area model and the standard algorithm for solving problems. Beyond that, there's a couple word problems, but they're pretty straightforward. So I expect that you shouldn't have too much of a difficulty finishing those up on your own. So let's get started with our multiplying decimal numbers by whole numbers using the area model and standard algorithm. Let's look at our instructions. They tell us to draw an area model, then solve using the standard algorithm. Use arrows to match up the partial products from the area model to the partial products of the algorithm. Let's start with our area model. Okay, we're going to multiply 34 times 21. So we're going to put, make a rectangle. We're going to keep it fairly simple with this, but they're going to get increasingly complex over time. We're going to put the first factor on the top. And we're going to decompose the second factor. We're going to start with the ones place and then go on to the tens place, decomposing 21 into 1 plus 20. Now these are pretty easy to do because we're working with some small factors here and there's not a lot of regrouping. As we go on, things are going to get more complex. So let's do the multiplication. I have 1 times 34, or 34 times 1, same thing, commutative property tells us that, and I get 34. Now I'm multiplying from the tens place. I've got two tens. So if I multiply 2 times 34, I get 68. But I have 68 tens, and 68 tens is the same as 680. Now let's solve this using the standard algorithm. 1 times 34 is 34. Now I'm multiplying from the tens place, so whatever I do, it's that many tens, and in our standard algorithm we just put a zero in that place to remind us that we are finding products that have an answer in the tens. So two tens times eight, four ones is eight ones, and two tens times three tens is six hundreds. Now we're going to solve the problem by finding our partial, adding our partial products. 4 in the ones place. I have an 11, regroup, and that becomes 7. So I have 714. Now we're supposed to match the partial product and the area model. You can see that what we did in our area model corresponds to our first partial product, and the second part of our area model corresponds with the second part of our partial product. Let's move along and do another example, and this will be a relatively short screencast, just two examples, but these examples tell us how to use the area model. Let's do another example just to make sure we have it. Again, we're going to be using both the area model and the standard algorithm. And again, these are fairly simple problems, so we're not going to go into as much decomposing as we will very soon in our future lessons. Let's look at our problem. We have 434 times 21. So we're going to draw an area model. We're going to take that and make a rectangle once again. We're going to put the first factor on the top, 434. We're going to once again decompose our second factor into the ones place and the tens place. So 21 has 1 1, and it has two tens, which is the same as 20. Let's multiply. 1 times 434 is 434. I multiply 1 times 4 ones, 1 times 3 tens is 3 tens, and 1 times 4 hundreds is 400s. Let's go on and do the next one. Since we're multiplying from the tens place, we're going to put in a zero right off the bat to remind us where we are in our place value. We'll discuss it as we go through the problem. I have 2 tens times 4 ones is 8 tens. I have 2 tens times 3 tens, that's 600s. I have 2 tens times 400s, which is 8 thousandths. And if you look at this, we have everything in the proper place. Let's now go over to our standard algorithm. First, we're multiplying from the ones place, just like we did in the area model. And I have 1 1 times 4 ones is 4 ones. I have 1 1 times 3 tens, which is 3 tens. And I have 1 1 times 400s, which is 400. Once again, since we are multiplying from the tens place here, we're going to put in that zero because we need to keep everything in its proper place, because this time we're multiplying 4 tens by, or 2 tens by 4 ones, and that gives us 8 tens. The next one is 2 tens times 3 tens, which is 600s. And finally, we have 2 tens times 400s, which is 8,000. We'll find the sum of our partial products, doing a regroup, and another regroup, and yet another regroup, and I get 9,114. And again, if we look at our area model over here, we can see that this corresponds with our first partial product when we multiplied from the ones place, and the second box, or the lower one, corresponds, whoops, wrong tool, and corresponds to our second partial product. So our answer is 9,114, and we will this time remember to put it up on the top, 9,114. That's a fairly short screencast, but it's a fairly simple lesson. You have to do 2 examples with both the area model and the standard algorithm. There will be 3 problems with the standard algorithm. Again, fairly simple problems. And the word problems are very straightforward. They're not multi-step. You should have no problem solving them on your own. Remember to make your diagrams and your statements of answer.